हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द क्लास। टुडे वी आर गोइंग फॉरवर्ड ओके टू द सेम टॉपिक अबाउट लास्ट क्लास व्हाट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड पावर्स एंड डिफरेंट पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ पावर। इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट जनरल पर्सपेक्टिव। नाउ वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द क्लास पर्सपेक्टिव। इन जनरल पर्सपेक्टिव वी हैव व्हाट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट we have discussed about the perspectives where the society is a combination of both male and female, so this is created by nature. Okay, so according to the feminist theory, what they wanted more freedom when compared to the male dominant society, etc. Okay, now we'll go forward for the class perspective. From the point of view, how the class perspective, already we have discussed what is meant by perspective, the mental views. Okay, now we will discuss about the introduction point, the concept of power is a key concept for all the aspects of political science. Okay, so distribution of power, when you are saying about distribution of power in the political community, that will resolve all the conflicts. Okay, we have to distribute the power. So whenever if you are distributing the distribution of power should be in such a way that all the problems must be resolved effectively. Resolution should be done effectively in such a way that everybody should accept all the resolutions. So whenever if you are finding any resolutions, so resolution should be done in such a way that everybody should accept. Okay, power is nothing but that will denotes the ability of a person or fulfill the desire. Whenever the people are fulfilling his desire, that is called as power. Now we'll discuss about what is called as class perspective. Class perspectives are mainly developed by Karl Marx and Friedrich Engels. What they have developed? Socialism. So in class perspective, Karl Marx and Friedrich Engels, they have developed the concept of socialism. Okay, and this concept was developed in 19th century. Okay, so this class perspective theories, this theory suggested political power is a product of economic power. So whatever the political power is there, that is a product of economic power. Already in the previous classes also we have discussed that economic and political, they both are quietly related to each other. When the people are economically well versed, then only they can concentrate upon politics. So economic power is a product, political power is a product of economic power. If you see that our civilization society at present, if you see the civilization society are mainly antagonist, mainly the society is mainly consists of have and have not. Have in the sense the society which possess many things, the person who are rich, they were called have. The person who does not have income, they were called have nots. So have and have nots we are seeing in the perspective of economic. Okay, economically rich they were have, economically poor they are have not. Okay, so on the basis of civilizations we can find, okay, the societies were mainly classified into ownership and non-ownership means of social production. So in the societies we can find some are owned but some are non-owned. So societies are basically classified into ownership as well as non-ownership means of social production. Societies, when you are seeing, the societies are mainly classified into dominant as well as dependent. Dominant classes are owned and means of social production, but the rest of the people in the societies were called as dependent. So these theories are believe that they should be the classless society. Society should not be divided in the class. So this theory, according to the class perspectives, they believe that the society should be a classless society. Okay, society should not be categorized into different class, otherwise differences will come. Whenever the societies will form, that should be a classless society. Okay, so what is a classless society? They wanted to bring this classless society through socialist revolution. So children, this class perspectives are mainly common to the socialism. So in socialism, all the people are common, all the people are similar. Okay, nobody is high, nobody is low, all the people are similar. All the means and productions were under the control of government in socialism. So that type of society, particularly in Russia, whatever the society which was formed in Russia, that is called as classless society. So what we have studied here about introduction. The concept of power is a very key concept in all the aspects of political science. So distribution of power should be in such a way that in political communities the conflicts must be resolved, and resolution should be effectively accepted by all the people. And power denotes that ability of person to fulfill the desire. And class perspectives are developed by Karl Marx and Friedrich Engels in 19th century. In 19th century, they have developed the class perspectives were developed by Friedrich Engels and Karl Marx. And this theory have proposed that political power is a product of economic power. So they wanted a civilized society is an antagonist society where most of the people are have and have not, rich and the societies are mainly classified into rich and poor people. Some peoples were owned heavy capital, but some does not have any type of ownership in the means of social protection. Okay, so in the societies we can find the classified into dominant and dependent. Dominant classes who are dominating others, okay, who have huge means of protection, who have owned many means of social protection. But dependents are nothing but the rest of the populations were called as dependent, who are depending on dominant class. So this theory, class perspectives are mainly beliefs on establishing the classless society, which is called as socialist revolution. So they wanted to bring the classless society by socialist revolution. That is one point. Okay. So if you see the class perspectives means in this point, these perspectives are denoting that they should be the society where classless society where all the people are should be equal, like socialism. Okay, so differences automatically will be decreases. So that is one point. So this theory was anciently proposed by Karl Marx and Friedrich Engels. Karl Marx is the father of scientific socialism. We have already discussed, and he have written many book, Communist Manifesto and Das Kapital in the 19th century by Karl Marx. Okay, and this theory have proposed political power is a product of economic power. So this theory have suggested that political power is a product of economic power, and this theory have suggested that there should be a civilized society which is called antagonist, which are mainly categorized into have and have not, and mainly this is based upon the ownership as well as non-ownership means of production. So this is about the class perspective, children. Okay, we will meet you in the next class with a new topic. Thank you very much.